have discussed the structure of prokaryotic cells as well as eukaryotic cells. And now we will be taking various parts of the cell. And the first is plasma membrane. This plasma membrane is also known as biomembrane or cell membrane. So we can use other terms also, biomembrane or cell membrane. It is also called a unit membrane based on the structure that it has. But before that, we will talk about the properties of plasma membrane and we will see what the nature is. Plasma membrane is made up of proteins and phospholipids. Phospholipids are diglyceride fats. When we come to the structure, we will see what molecules are attached to make this phospholipid. Then it is a selectively permeable membrane. Selectively permeable. What is meant by this term selectively permeable? Our plasma membrane is a porous membrane. That means there are pores in our plasma membrane and the pore size is also fixed. To understand what is meant by this selectively permeable membrane, let us say this is the membrane, this is inside of the cell, this is outside. If outside has some particles which are to be taken in, or these are the particles, which particle can go in? If the membrane is semi-permeable, not selectively, semi-permeable, then entry of the particle depends according to the pore size. That means the smaller particles which can cross this pore, they can go in. In that case, we will call the membrane semi-permeable. So, semi-permeable term is used where particles enter according to the pore size. That means if a particle can cross this pore, then it will go in. Now, this particle which is going in could be a good particle, required particle, or could be a harmful substance. But if it can cross the pore, it will go in. Then in that case, we will call the membrane semi-permeable. When would we call this membrane selectively permeable? According to pore, all three can go in. But say, for example, this particle is not required. Then a selectively permeable membrane will not let this particle go in, though it can cross the pore. That means smaller particles also, which are not required, they will not be allowed in. Larger particles which cannot cross this pore and are required by the cell, then the cell is going to take it. Say for example this one. If it is required, the cell is going to take it. Plasma membrane will help in taking this substance. How will this substance come in? It could come in through endocytosis. That means here there would be a folding or a cup-like structure formed. This larger particle would be taken in. That means the membrane selects which particle to be taken in. Smaller, if not needed, will not be taken in. Larger, if not able to cross the pore, will still be taken in. That means the membrane selects. And then we call this membrane as selectively permeable. If you read different types of books on this plasma membrane, for plasma membrane, both the terms are used, selectively permeable as well as semi-permeable. The point here is, it is a selectively permeable membrane as long as it is a part of the cell. Once you take it out of the cell, that means it is out of the living system and it is simple a membrane. Then it is going to act as a semi-permeable membrane. So, selectively, our membrane is selectively permeable, but as long as it is a part of the living system. And that is why when we do an experiment, what we do is we take a beaker in which dilute hydrochloric acid is taken. And we put an egg into this. So this egg, which is dipped here or which is put in this hydrochloric acid, its shell is made up of calcium carbonate. So slowly, because of the reaction of calcium carbonate and the acid, the shell starts to dissolve. So this shell slowly is going to disappear. And what gets exposed is the plasma membrane. And once this plasma membrane is taken, and we can use it as a semi-permeable membrane. But when this plasma membrane was a part of the egg, it was acting as a selectively permeable membrane. Now when we separate it from this egg, then it is acting as a semi-permeable membrane. So structure doesn't change, only thing is the condition, which is making it selectively permeable or semi-permeable. The properties which are shown by plasma membrane, and these properties only will help us choose the model that could explain all these properties. First property is that it is selectively permeable. It allows the entry of water-soluble and fat-soluble substances. Selectively permeable, and it will help in water-soluble substances to come in, as well as fat-soluble substance can also cross the plasma membrane. Second thing, it shows variable protein to phospholipid ratio. The ratio of protein to phospholipids is variable in a plasma membrane. And third, our plasma membrane is fluidic or dynamic. There are two words which we use. One is static, other is dynamic. Static word is used when the structure is rigid or firm or same. A dynamic term is used when it shows variations. So this is a dynamic membrane. So these are the three properties which are shown by plasma membrane. So what we know about plasma membrane is, before we come to the model, that this is a protein phospholipid layer. It is selectively permeable. We have also understood what is meant by selective permeability. And these are the three properties which are shown by plasma membrane. We know that water-soluble substances also go in. Variable ratio, we will understand which model explains it. And dynamic membrane, that it shows flexibility changes. This formation of a vesicle is actually a flexibility. And this is possible only when the membrane has or is capable of changing or is slightly fluidic or semi-solid type of. So there are various models which were proposed to explain the structure of plasma membrane. There are more than 50 models which have been proposed. But we would be talking about three models which explain the model of plasma membrane, and we will check all these three models on these three properties. Whichever model explains these three properties, that model will be accepted. And if it is not able to explain these properties, then we are going to reject that model. So in the next part, we will be talking about the first model of plasma membrane which was given. And that model which we would be discussing is sandwich model, which was given by Danieli and Dabson.